Today we are changing eye color. What's up, ladies and gentlemen? I'm Inazalea, and in today's video, we're going to see how to change your eye color to whatever color you want in Adobe After Effects. I already used this technique in a few different videos. Lately, you've seen it in Fallen. Music clip that I directed and edited. If you haven't seen that, a link is in the description. It's a pretty awesome song by my bro Levito. But there are many ways on doing this effect. If you have blue eyes, you're already a lucky one, because then we can manipulate the blue color into different colors a little bit easier than we can with brown colors. But if you have brown eyes, you can still do that effect if you have a well-lit scene. Unfortunately, I have those much more beautiful but brown eyes, which are harder for applying effects. Anyway, I'm up for a challenge. If you enjoy watching this video, be sure to give it a like. Also, be sure to subscribe to the channel and hit the notification bell so you get notified when I upload new videos. So the first thing that I did is imported my footage in Adobe After Effects, of course. And I still had some footage from Halloween where I was doing the vampire teeth tutorial. And a vampire without white or red eyes isn't really a vampire. So we're going to use this footage as an example. So as I said, it's really important to have well-lit eyes. It's so important. So make sure you are not in the shadow or anything. Place yourself in front of a window or light your eyes with artificial lights like I'm doing right now. If you see those kind of white reflections, you're good to go. If you want the same footage as me, I'll put a link in the description below so you can follow along with the exact same footage as me. So after you've imported your footage, drag it to the new composition icon in your project manager. This will make a new composition with the exact same timing, FPS and resolution of your shot. Then next we will use a tracking tool to track our pupil. If you don't see this panel, simply go to Window Tracker. In here you want to track the motion and only the position, so it's a pretty simple track. Go to the frame where you see the pupil very clearly and then make a tracking area exactly on the pupil. The inner square is the tracking region and the bigger or outer square is the search area. I tend to make this one bigger so the track knows better where to look, something like this, and then hit the track backwards button if you are in the center of your video clip. And then after you've done that, go back to that initial start frame and then track forward. Once your entire track is done, we want to create a new null object in our composition. Right click, new, null object, and rename it right eye track. This you will need to do again once you start on the other eye. So you'll have to track the right eye and then create a new null object for the left eye. I will only show you one eye as the workflow is exactly the same. Once you've created your null, now get into your tracking panel and here select the null object. Then go with the time scrubber to the beginning of the composition. This is really important and hit apply. It will ask you for X and Y. Just click OK and boom, you have a track on the pupil. Now create a new adjustment layer, choose your circular mask tool and make a circle around your eye. Now you have an adjustment layer with your eye selected, but it still has some overlapping over the eyelids, which we will need to fix in a second. Now you must parent this layer to your null that contains the tracking info. To do that, simply use the pick whip tool and select your null object. For the other eye, you'll need to create a new adjustment layer, create a circle and then parent it to the new tracked null. Now we need to key out the eye white space so the circle doesn't overflow on the eyelid. To do this, I will use a new and awesome tool that came in the latest version of Adobe After Effects CC 2019. If you don't have this version yet, you can simply mask out this part. It will only take longer. So above the adjustment layer with the circle of the eye masked out, we want to create a new solid layer. So right click, new and solid layer. This is going to be our alpha matte. Leave it for now and then select your original footage layer. Now I'll go to effects and presets and search for the Mocha AECC. This is the new tool that now is inside of Adobe After Effects, so you don't need to leave the area. This allows you to open up a new version of Mocha inside of Adobe After Effects, so you don't need to leave the area. Awesome. It also works a lot faster than before, and I'm simply in love with the new update. I had a big rotoscoping job the other day, and that was just when they released this update. I use this effect all the time, and it saved me so much time. It's incredible. If I didn't have Mocha, I would have killed myself probably, but yeah. Anyway, once you have the Mocha effect applied to your layer, you'll see that you have a Mocha logo on the top, and if you click that, you'll open up the Mocha workspace. Here I want you to go to a location where you see the eye very clearly. The beginning in my case is perfect for that. So then I'll select the X-spline tool and click around my eye until I have a complete mask of the eye white. Right click to finish your mask, and now we will click this track forward button. Let it track the entire eye, stop the track where needed, and adjust the mask. It won't do a perfect job, but this mask is here to guide us through the process. Once it's finished, play it back and see if it masked perfectly, otherwise adjust where needed. Close the Mocha window, click save. Now we want to disable the Mocha effect and open the panel. And here you'll see create AE mask. Click that and this will transfer our tracked mask to a mask inside of Adobe After Effects. This mask will be applied to our footage, so we don't want that. So I will click on my mask, I will click Ctrl X to cut it away, and I will go to the beginning of the timeline and select the alpha matte solid layer that we created a little while ago. Here I want to paste this mask info. Make sure the solid layer is on top of the eye adjustment layer and click track matte alpha matte. If you don't see this, simply toggle the switches or hit F4 on the keyboard. We're halfway there. You can also use some feathering and some mask expansion to really narrow down the effects and make them blend in a little bit better. So now all that less is to do is adjust the actual eye color. For this, I will select the adjustment layer of the eye, apply three effects. The first one is exposure, next hue saturation, and then lastly levels. I like to use these three effects in combination to really create my colors that I want to play around with a little bit. Now it's simply a matter of playing around with these effects to get your desired results. I like to bring up the exposure quite a bit. You can lower the saturation in the hue saturation effect and then bring up the black to create these kind of white zombie eyes, which are really cool. You can also reset the hue and increase the hue radius to change the actual color, adjust the contrast with the levels, and that's basically it on how to change your eye colors. So as you can see in the preview, you really can achieve any kind of color as long as you have well lit eyes. It's quite an easy process, it's all a matter of playing around. You can also use images, but those tend to look a little bit fake rather quickly. But that way you can also kind of get these kind of snake eyes or different things. And if you have a badly lit scene, you will need to use kind of eye textures to cover up the actual eyes. So that's also something you can play around with. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, give this video a like. Also, be sure to subscribe to the channel and hit the notification bell to stay notified when I upload new videos. Apart from that, check out our website. We have a bunch to offer for any kind of digital creative. And if you buy something from our website, it helps to support this channel. So that would be completely awesome. And apart from that, I just hope to see you guys in the next one. Goodbye.